Hello students, this is the 10th video of our first module, and in this video I'm going to explain you about the constants. So constants are again the C tokens. So in the last video I was explaining you about the keywords and identifiers, which are also the C tokens. Along with them we are also going to use the constants, which are the C tokens. So we will study in detail what are constants, what are the different types of constants we have, how we are going to use them in the program and other things. So coming to the constants, constant is nothing but it is a fixed value. So it is a fixed value that cannot be changed during the execution of a program. So its value cannot be changed during the execution of a program. So what are the different types of constants we have? So based on what type of value it will hold, we have different types of constants. So numeric constant and character constant. So if it holds a numeric value, then it is called as numeric constants. If holds the character values, then it is called as a character constants. So in numeric constants, again, we have two different types. One is integer constant, the other one is real constant. If it holds only the whole part, then it is called as an integer constant. If it holds the decimal part also, fractional part also, then we call it as real constants. Character constants, again, it is of two different types, single character constants and string constants. Single character means only one character will be set as a constant value. So it is called as single character constants. If we are going with the multiple characters, a group of characters means, then we call it as string constants. And also we have one more type of constant called as backslash character constant. So all these things we will be studying in detail. Coming to the numeric constants. Integer constants. So first numeric constant is integer constant, and this integer constant refers to the sequence of digits. So there are three different types of integer constants. So first one is decimal integer constant, second one is octal integer constant, third one is hexadecimal integer constant. So coming to the decimal integer constant, so the set of digits 0 through 9, which will be preceded by the optional sign, that plus or minus. So it is called as a decimal integer. So only the numbers from 0 through 9 can be used in our a number representation. So here we have few examples: 123 and minus 321, 0, 654321, plus 78. So these are the examples of our decimal integer. So maximum 9 and minimum 0 has to be the number which we are going to include for our decimal integer. Similarly, octal integers means they are the numbers with the combination of the digits either from 0 through 7. Octal means till 8, 8 numbers should be there, but 0 through 7 means they will be the 8 numbers in total. So we will be considering 0 through 7. So we have few examples here: 037, 037, 0, 0435, 0551. So all these numbers in common, they are having 0 at the beginning of each number. So 0 represents the octal number. So that if we are using that particular 0 at the beginning of all the numbers, then that number, type of number, it is called as octal number. Similarly, hexadecimal number means it consists of the combination of digits from 0 through 15, but here we are going to use the characters A to F in order to represent the two digits numbers, like 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 will be represented from A and F. So if we use the prefix 0x, either it may be small x or capital X, it will be representing the hexadecimal number. Then coming to the real constants. Real constants means they will be consisting of the fractional parts also, like 99.25. So whole part as well as fractional part, if the number contains, then it is called as a real constant. Then it is also of two types: decimal form and exponential form. So floating point numbers, they can be represented in two forms. One is decimal form, the other one is exponential form. If we want to represent the decimal form, then it must include a decimal point and the exponent. Real part, decimal point followed by the exponent. And representing the exponential form means it has to contain the integer part, fractional part, both, and also it has to contain the E, that is signed exponent value. It is represented with E. We are having few examples here: 1.2, plus 9.0, minus 4.5. These represents the floating point numbers, decimal numbers. If we want to go with the exponential form means it has to include plus or minus sign, followed by the mantissa, then E, letter, which represents the exponential form, plus or minus sign followed by the exponent value. So here we have few examples: plus 1e23, minus 9e2, plus 2e minus 25. So all these are nothing but the exponential representation of our real constants. So if in exponential notation, the mantissa can be specified either in a decimal or fractional form. An exponent can be written in both uppercase as well as lowercase e. Small e or capital E can be used to represent the exponential form. We can use both the signs, that is positive and negative, before the mantissa as well as exponent value. Spaces should not be allowed. So based on these conditions, we have few constant representations which are valid or not valid based on the remarks given here. Plus 5.0e3 means yes, it is valid because it is consisting of sign. It doesn't have any space in between and it has an exponent value also. Yes, it is typical as a real constant representation. 3.5e.5. This also is a valid real constant. But here, third one, 7.1e, one space is left in between e and 4. So it is not a valid real constant because white spaces have been included. 1.5e plus 2.5. Exponent should must be an integer value. It cannot be the fractional value. So this is minus, this is not point. So these are the different examples for our real constants. Then coming to the character constants, it simply contains a single character enclosed within single quotes, a pair of single quotes. If we are going to use it, then whatever value is enclosed within the single quotes, either it may be a character or it may be a number or it may be any special symbol or also it may be any white spaces. So the character sets, whatever character sets we have seen before, it will be consisting of the letters, digits, special symbols as well as white spaces. So all of them, if they are enclosed within a single quote, then we call it as a character constant. So each character constant, it will be representing the ASCII value. If we want to know the ASCII value of that particular character set, then it will be like if you want to print, means a percentage D, if you give, then it will be printing its ASCII value. ASCII stands for American Standard Code for Information Interchange. Similarly, string constants means these are the sequence of characters. If it contains more than one characters which are enclosed within a double quotes, if you want to specify some name like hello 2015, 2 plus 1, if everything is enclosed within a double quotes means, then it is called as a string constant. So these are the examples for our string constant. Then coming to the last type of character constant, backslash character constant. C supports some character constants having a backslash in front of it. The list of backslash characters have a specific meaning which is known to the compiler. Already the compiler will be knowing the meaning, so it can be used where and all it is required. They are also termed as the escape sequences. So slash A, slash B, slash F, slash N, slash R, slash T, slash V, and slash single quote, slash double quote, slash backslash, then slash zero. So all these are the few backslash character constants which we have. They'll be having their own specific meaning and they can be used wherever it is required. Commonly used ones are new line character, horizontal tab, vertical tab, and null characters can be used. So this is about the constants.